Matthew McConaughey goes to the dark side in Killer Joe. He had doubts about taking on the most violent role of his career.
I was disgusted with the material. I didn't see any humor in it. I didn't want to be a part of the world. And I went back and reread it after talking to some friends of mine whose opinion I appreciate, and I found the humor. I don't know who this guy is yet, Joe, but I'm willing now to go dive in and figure out who he is.
Matthew is a detective who moonlights as a hitman for hire. He told me what scared him about becoming a remorseless killer.
Not knowing how to play the guy or how to be the guy.
Tuna casserole.
Yes.
May I serve?
To the bottom of it all, he lives a very structured life. As a hitman and as a cop, it's very clear his rules. He needs order. If things are out of order, he cannot, honestly, cannot live with it. He cannot stand it.
How are you going to kill my mama?
Oh, that's not appropriate dinner conversation, Donnie.
When his world plunges into chaos, Killer Joe wreaks havoc. Matthew wasn't apologizing to the rest of the cast for the scenes of blood and gore.
You can't do that. You can, but I think it'd be the wrong way to go. That's what's fun about being an actor and going to a set and going to work. It's a safe place to create. And you don't really want to break that wall and step outside after some of these scenes and go, oh my God, I'm so sorry. No, I'm not sorry. That would let you know, oh, we were all just faking, it was all fun and games. That's not good for the other actor.
Off screen, I got the scoop on how Matthew feels since his recent walk down the aisle with his pregnant wife, Camila.
Congratulations about being married.
Thank you.
Do you feel completely different now that you're a married man?
Not completely different. not completely different, but I just feel even better.
Great.
Good.
I'm Jeannie Wolf on the Hollywood Scene with Killer Joe.